Today, we're going to talk about how to learn data science in 2021, even if you're a complete beginner. Well, first of all, let's talk about the three key components in data science, which are programming, mathematics and statistics, and also the domain knowledge. Let's first talk about programming. We learn programming in data science to handle data processing and analysis tasks. And this includes collect data, clean data, explore data, build predictive models, and interpret the results. Or you might want to ask, hey, Dr. Lau, can we use softwares like Excel or Power BI to do this? Yes, you can. But bear in mind that these softwares are not designed for data science. For example, Excel is designed for handling spreadsheet data in the forms of rows and columns, so it won't be able to handle unstructured data with high dimensions such as document, image, audio, and videos. And Power BI is a business intelligence tool, which we mainly use to create reports, dashboards, and visualizations. These tools are good for data analysis, but not for analyzing large amounts of data or to build machine learning models. And the most popular programming language for data science is Python. Python is an open source programming language, which means you can use it for free. You don't even need to be a programmer or software engineer to practice data science. You just need to learn the basics on how to store data using variables, how to process data using loops, and how to make decisions using the if-else statements. And then, pick up a few data processing libraries in Python. You can start with Pandas, which is a library to import data from different data sources, and also for us to massage and analyze data. And you can also learn Seaborn, which is a visualization library that allows us to produce beautiful and professional charts. The second thing that you need in data science is mathematics and statistics. And many people try to avoid mathematics and statistics as much as they can, including myself. Because that brings back the old memories of our high school, which we were told to memorize many equations and formulas, but we forget about them right after the exam. And the main reason behind is because we didn't really learn how to apply mathematics and statistics to solve real-world problems, such as how long should I queue outside a restaurant before I decide to give up? Is LeBron James or Michael Jordan the best basketball player? Or we can use it to answer more statistical questions like, will it rain tomorrow? Or is this email a spam? Learning mathematics and statistics in data science is for us to know the techniques behind machine learning algorithms so that we will know which one to use and when to use them. Here are some of the mathematics and statistics topics that's enough to kickstart your data science journey. First of all, learn discrete math. Discrete math is not as hard as it sounds. It's basically the foundation of data science and computer science. Learn how to count objects, calculate the combinations, permutations, and probabilities. And these are some good basic skills to start with. Secondly, learn statistics. Statistics allow us to gain deeper insights into our data so that we can know the underlying structures, distributions, and the patterns of our data. And lastly, regressions. Regression analysis is an important tool for building models. We learn how to fit a curve or line to our data points so that we can estimate the relationships between variables and build models for predictions. The third component, which is also what I consider the most important component in data science, is domain knowledge. In today's world, finding answers is easy with tools like Google, Quora, Stack Overflow. And what is hard is for us to ask the right questions. Like Charles Kettering once said, a problem well stated is a problem half solved. And how can you state a problem clearly without good domain knowledge? Many data scientists make this mistake by getting too excited with the projects and they jump in quickly to get their hands dirty without having a clear big picture of the problem they are trying to solve. And this leads to making wrong assumptions and wasting time working on something that ultimately does not deliver any results. And therefore, domain knowledge helps to make sure that we are asking the right questions, gather the necessary data, and evaluate the performance of our model correctly, and making sure that our answers are actually applicable. In a nutshell, what makes data science interesting is because we get to solve challenging business problems using the wide variety of tools that are available for us. There's no specific sequence that whether you should learn programming or mathematics first, or you can learn them together side by side and see how they can be applied in your own industry. And let me know whether you would like to learn mathematics, statistics, or programming first, and I will see you in the next video.